We just need to retweak our economy, our people, and our resources. Open the eyes of our people so they can see how easy it is to create wealth. Get government to be responsive, to make government support systems, provide systems, and ease of doing business. We need the politicians to open their eyes and forget about the old style of doing politics. Politics should not be about thuggery and forcing people and rigging elections. It should be about adding value to society. Money should continue to flow in the streets of Nigeria. The populace, all they need is enlightenment. Our education system needs to be retweaked. Government needs to overhaul our education system so we don't regurgitate graduates who cannot defend their results and their qualification. We need to do something about artisans so that we can actually have vocational schools that can make people who cannot go to school have the pride of the dignity of labor, that they've learned something and they can use it to create wealth. All the empowerment agencies have to be reorganized. Empower, Niger Delta Amnesty, Northeast Development Fund. We need to reorganize these empowerment agencies. The number of people that they can empower is too small compared to the demand of unemployment and poverty. So what they are doing, people are not feeling it. And the money they are investing in those programs can do 100 times what they are doing now, and it will be more far-reaching if they apply strategies that can make government provide the enabling environment for private sector like us, who empower people with the education and exposure that they need to create wealth. Where they don't need $1 to start business, and all they require is to be reorientated in their mindset, the way they think and the way they see things.
Now, when you ask these empowerment agencies, what is their challenge? They will tell you that funds is the basically challenging power is to produce.
Because they don't know what to do. You don't need money to create an enabling environment. The money is there. We have a lot of donor and development agencies who come to Nigeria with money to support causes. They're not able to implement it. Because the bureaucracy of government makes it impossible for them to see those opportunities and how they can implement what they have to implement. They are not Nigerians, so they don't know who are Nigerians and where the problem is. When they go to government, the bureaucracy slows them down. When they try to use public sector and private sector companies, they are clouded with 409 briefcase companies who set up companies just to defraud development agencies. But if government can create the enabling environment to invite these development agencies together and get private sector people to come on a round table and present what they have to offer to Nigeria. In that presentation, as we showcase the private sector people, those donor agencies will pick the one that they want to partner with. If Empower, the Vice President's office, brings those development agencies together and call Nigerians who have value to offer to come to a round table to do a presentation, they will be able to match those people together. And the impact and the money and the influx of money that will come to Nigeria to solve unemployment, you cannot imagine it. It's of Nigeria. You don't need a dime to start a business. Government should come with the realization that we need to reorientate the mindset of our people to begin to see the opportunities that we have out there. You can start a shop without $1 in your pocket. You can use any item in the market to make $1 million a month. Sell the capital of 20,000 naira. You can open a school without $1 in your pocket. I am open to working and collaborating with government agencies. With my organization, FMG Platform, for us to be able to come together and create the enabling environment to open the eyes of Nigerians to the opportunities that are bound and the fears that hold them from getting what they want to get, like the fear of not having enough education, the fear of no godfather to help them, the fear of not having capital to do the business, the fear of not having employment that holds a lot of them at home. We can disabuse their mind that with or without those things, they will be able to succeed. Nigeria is still looking at giving money to people to support them to do things that will empower them. If you give me money to empower me, and I finish using that money and the money is completely utilized, I will go back to where I'm coming from. The amnesty program has empowered a lot of people, but educating them more to add to the people that are unemployed in the unemployment market. How have you solved unemployment? How have you solved poverty? Today, Empower is doing a lot. But how many people are they empowered compared to the number of people that need empowerment? If you use that money to create a school where people can be exposed free of charge on how they can start business without one naira, you will take a lot of people from the unemployment market. And in that unemployment market, employment will be created that will double and reduce the number of employment. I can reduce unemployment in Nigeria by over 30% given the opportunity. The problem is that we don't have the people in government ready to work with the private sector people. The government works with people that don't understand how to solve the problem. When grants are given, they are given to towers who cannot use the grant to duplicate what they need to duplicate to reduce the level of employment. We have just appointed ministers. Let the Minister of Labour and Productivity, let the Minister of Youth and Sports, let the Minister of Women Affairs connect with us. We will reduce unemployment by over 30%. I challenge them and I'm willing to work with them. As for the President, he has a lot to do and everybody is looking up to him. I know he has the will to do it. The problem is, who are the people he's using to implement it? If he doesn't get the right set of people, he will continue to make a mess of the whole thing. A tree cannot make a forest. But he has the right people around him, and if they do the right things, we will see the change that he desires in Nigeria. He has the right intention, he has the right objective, and he wants to solve Nigeria's problem. But he's frustrated by the people he's working with. Maybe it has to do with the party system. He has a party that has not changed. Because the same party that has ruled us in the past how many years are the same party still in government, and they are not changing in any way, and he wants to have a change. So there's a dilemma in his operations. He cannot do without appointing his party members. The party members are making statements to the world that they are the same people. So how will change come? We in the private sector are willing to work with him. He should identify the people that he needs to work with so that we can solve the problem of Nigeria. But what we need to solve the problem of Nigeria is in Nigeria. Take out tribalism, take out religion, make everybody feel as Nigerians. We will solve Nigeria's problem.